Om Shanti, how are you all? So we are going to discuss about a very important topic. Let me start with a true incident. There is a brother who has some problem over property issues with his brother. So his younger brother was saying in a fight that he himself has a drunken habit. And how about you? That is, he is asking his elder brother to reveal his weakness after revealing his own weakness. So the elder brother now smiles at him and says, "Go and do your work, brother." Which means his younger brother couldn't trace any weakness from his elder brother. So this elder brother is so good. So that's the real victory. It doesn't mean his younger brother is not going to cheat on him on his property. He will definitely cheat his property. But the main reason that I said that this is the true success is because no matter how bad anybody is, they always look for some kind of reason that convinces them of their bad doing. If somebody steals, they convince themselves that they have no money, the society is doing working against them, all sort of things like that. And if somebody is going to kill somebody in the name of property or religion or whatever, they will come out with some reason as if something bad has happened to him that triggered him to do so. So, here, the main thing that we need to pay more attention to is we should never give such reason to anybody around us, whether it's our brother or sister or father or mother or our children or our grandchildren or our best friend or our teacher, whoever it is. We should not give them such reason, which means we should be the best father to our parents or best mother, sorry, to our children. We should be the best child to our parents, and not only best, but also the true child, true parent, true husband, true wife. So you should be true and best in all aspects so that they don't find any reason to cheat on you except for their own weakness. If a girl cheats on his husband, it should be purely because of her lust, and not because the husband beats her or he's a drunkard. There shouldn't be such reason for her. Because obviously everybody cheats due to their own weakness, but still they cling on to some reason, some weakness of their husband or their wives as a reason for them to cheat. So don't give such reason. Be the best husband, no matter how your wife is. Let her cheat. Let your husband cheat. It's okay. But let them do it out of their own weakness. They shouldn't pull you as a reason for their wrong behavior. Even after knowing the other person is cheating on you in terms of money or relationship, still be as good as possible. So what difference does it make? Anyway, they are going to cheat on you. But now their conscience bites continuously. They will never rest in peace, because even after grabbing your property illegally without facing any opposition from you, still they can't be at peace, because their mind will talk to them continuously that what they did is wrong, and they'll be looking for some reason to satisfy their mind. Don't give it. Never give it. Just be as good as possible, no matter how much pain they give you. So that's the actual punishment for them. And for you, since you haven't posed any threat even to your enemies, so everybody will view you as the best person in terms of all relationships. So you are trustworthy. Even you, if you are left alone without any money, without any relationship, people will be more happy to offer you any sort of job at any point of time. Not only that, God loves such person, because that's the character represented by Yudhishthir in Mahabharata and also all the leading characters in Bible and Quran. And now you don't have to live in shame while the other person will. And you can face the world very boldly and very peacefully, because you didn't oppose anybody, you didn't hurt anybody. But how is it possible? Is it possible for everybody? It's very easy to say that. But is it possible? Of course it's not possible on our own, because we souls have lost the power to face such betrayal. So that's why people commit suicide or commit murder. So what should we do now? We have to accumulate the power in our soul directly from the Supreme Soul, God, God Shiva, who is also called Allah or Heavenly Godfather by other religions. So he is a point of light, residing in the golden red colored light world called Parandham or Parlok. And that is where we souls resided before taking birth in earth. The only difference between souls and Supreme Soul is we enter this birth and death cycle that lasts for 5,000 years, while God always stays away from this cycle except in the end, where he enters an old man's body. Even then he didn't take birth like us as a child. Instead, he enters an old man's body directly and he names him Brahma, who was glorified as Adam in Bible and Quran. And he starts giving these teachings through the mouth of Brahma. And those teachings are called Murali. It's available totally free of cost in all Rajyoga meditation centers across the globe. And also you can find Murali in all languages online, in many websites, in YouTube. You can find it both in audio form, text form, video form. So it is there. So the spelling goes M-U-R-L-I. So it's not M-U-R-A-L-I, but M-U-R-L-I, Murali. So you search for it, you read it for yourself, then you will know for it yourself that it is indeed the word of God. By listening to Murali daily, without fail, you will see the change happening gradually over time. Not only that, we need to remember God as a point of light. And also we need to remember ourselves as a point of light constantly, because we are actually the souls that resides as a point of light in between the eyebrows. It is the soul that operates this body, and we are not this body. So we had this consciousness when we were in heaven in the beginning. Yes, this world was heaven in the beginning. God created this earth as heaven. But after 2500 years, the world which was heaven in the beginning gradually turned to hell. How? By becoming body consciousness. Yes, we were soul conscious for the first 2500 years when we were in heaven as deities. And when we reached hell, we become body conscious, out of which we became addicted to the five vices like lust, anger, greed, attachment and ego, because of which we started committing more and more sins, because of which we are facing more and more punishment in terms of diseases, natural calamities, and all sorts of relationship problems, and so on. And now God says that this world is going to be heaven very soon, within the next 20 years. So the same soul that is within us is going to enter heaven and take a new body. So, but the soul within our body is not eligible to enter heaven as of now because it's impure. It is corrupted with all those vices. So, to wash off the sins, all we need to do is to remember the ever-pure God as a point of light. The more we remember God, the more we become pure, just like God. And also we have to keep our mind busy with the knowledge given by God. And also we need to remember our aim of becoming Sri Narayan, which is the greatest post or status in heaven. So that should be our aim, and we should always remember these three: God as a point of light, our inheritance from God, which is the highest status, Sri Narayan, and the knowledge called Murali. So if we keep our mind always busy with these things, then it is very easy for us to express the divine characters like love, peace, even towards those who hurt you so badly, those who cheat you so badly. You can still reveal your divine character, and they will feel you as if God is, as if they are standing in front of God. You can always make it happen. Just by doing so, now we are being worshipped for the last 2500 years in hell by Hindus. Yes, all those deities Hindus worship now, they are none but us in our earlier stage, in the first 2500 years. So we are going to enter heaven again. So that's the good news, that we don't want to keep it to ourselves, right? So we must share this to everybody as much as possible. So please do share this video with your friends and relatives. And also, if you like this video, do hit the like button and leave your valuable comments, and do subscribe if you haven't. So, in summary, the real hero is the one who stays calm no matter what happens around him. No matter how the other person hurt him. So, the only way to be so is to stay in remembrance of God as much as possible. Om Shanti. Thanks for watching.